Hey guys, what's going on? I'm Rob Thomas, and I'm so excited to be here to spread some Christmas joy with you guys and to talk about my song, New York Christmas. Now, all the guys at Hallmark have sent me some questions that they want me to relay some answers to you guys so you guys can know a little bit more about me and my Christmas behaviors. So we're going to go through these questions right now, starting with this one. Your fans love your song, A New York Christmas. That's pretty presumptuous. And a new version is featured on your holiday album, Something About Christmas Time. Can you tell us what about that song makes it perfect for the holidays? Well, you know, as a New Yorker, I wrote this song 20 years ago, right after 9/11. It was my love letter to all my friends that didn't live in New York to let them know that we were okay. And since this was the 20th anniversary of that Christmas, and I was putting out this Christmas record, it seemed only fitting that I would kind of update it so that I could let people know, because it seems like we were all still here, you know, wanting to let people know that we were okay. So, hey, we're doing okay. What inspired you to write A New York Christmas, and what was it like getting to re-record the song almost 20 years? Well, you know, I talked about why we did it 20 years later, but I think I was a little on the fence. You know, I kind of always feel like if you make a record and you make any song, that's a snapshot of who you are. And that was who I was 20 years ago. And I wasn't sure if I wanted to update it, but I kind of felt like because this record, it was the 20th anniversary, and because it kind of embodied everything about me, and being a New Yorker at Christmas is a really big part of who I am. And I was glad that I did. I'm really happy with how it came out. And because of that, I think that's why Hallmark is using it. So I think I was on to something. A New York Christmas is making this countdown to Christmas even more special. Thanks. It's going to be featured in this Saturday's premiere of A Royal Queen's Christmas. That's a mouthful, by the way. A Royal Queen's Christmas. What does being a part of a countdown to Christmas in the Hallmark Channel family mean to you? I'm not lying when I tell you people right now that if I turn this camera around, the Hallmark Channel is on right behind the camera. It is on. It was on during the Christmas in July. It is on when October 22nd, when the Christmas started. Being a part of Christmas this year with my first Christmas album, and being able to do things like do the parade on the Hallmark float and do things like this, and to be a part of this new premiere movie, it's kind of everything for us, because in our home, Hallmark means Christmas. You and your beautiful wife love to watch the countdown of Christmas movies. Do you each have a favorite? Well, we fight about it. We love Most Wonderful Time of the Year, even though we know that originally it wasn't a Lifetime. I mean, it wasn't a Hallmark movie, but it was bought out later by Hallmark. And we also love A Very Merry Mix-Up, and we love Snow Bride, and we love Crown for Christmas, and we love A Royal Christmas. We love them all. Just keep them coming, please. What is your ideal movie watching setup, and do you have any snacking traditions while watching Hallmark Christmas movies? Okay, our setup is something like this. Okay, it's literally this. Our setup is literally right here with this tree behind us and the TV in front of us. But as far as snacking goes, the only thing I think that might be a little different than your traditional Christmas snacking is that we are a savory couple. So we are more likely to be having little pizza bites than milk and cookies. We're more likely to have pigs in a blanket than brownies. But that's the kind of people that we are. But somehow, I know this is kind of gross, we would still like... I think like we would have like a nice tea with some pizza bites instead of cocoa, and because once I start the cocoa, it doesn't stop ever. Okay, A New York Christmas gets us all in the festive spirit, and we're certain the fans are singing along when they hear it. Do you have a favorite lyric from the song? You know, I do actually. So there's a line in it in the chorus that says, "Hear the sidewalk angels echo hallelujah," and when I wrote that line, it was the impetus for my wife starting our foundation, Sidewalk Angels Foundation, that we started 18 years ago. And now over the last 18 years, we've been able to help over 20 something no-kill shelters and rescues with all their medical needs and building runs and doing large scale rescues all over the world at this point. So I think that line took on a life of its own, and I'm really glad whenever I hear it. Singing Christmas songs is a wonderful way to spread Christmas cheer, just like an elf. What was it like getting to perform on Hallmark Channel's float during the Thanksgiving Day Parade? Okay, listen. The best way I can explain this, because first off, like being here, being in New York, being on the other side of the parade every year and watching it and being able to be a part of it in itself was something that's really, really special. It's to see the magnitude of how big it is. You can never see it on television the way that you are right there. But the best way that I can describe being on the Hallmark float is kind of like 23 years ago, I went to the Grammys with Carlos Santana. And it was a supernatural record. And that was the record of the year. You were rolling in with like Michael Jackson's Thriller of the year, right? It was really, really big deal. When you show up on the Hallmark float at the Thanksgiving Day parade, that's like rolling in with Carlos Santana and the Supernatural record. That is like, you're rolling in with Christmas and everybody knows it. There's respect on that float. You better respect it. I just got really angry at Christmas. I apologize, but you know, I get passionate about Christmas. All right, Countdown to Christmas is all about celebrating traditions, making the time of year memorable. What are your favorite holiday traditions you enjoy doing with your family? We've come to learn over the years, over these many, many years, that what it is about Christmas is it's not the getting set up and then doing things. The setting up is the doing things. So like for us, the decorating of the tree is part of the Christmas, and each little step along the way and all the little things that we decorate around the house and all those things, that's really all part of those Christmas. And they all lead up to Christmas Eve, where my wife and I will watch It's a Wonderful Life, and we will have moussaka. She'll make moussaka. And then that's been our tradition, because honestly, I think 22 years ago on a Christmas together, we sat down and we did it. And then we just kept doing it every year. And so that's how traditions are born. In the spirit of Countdown to Christmas and your album, Something About Christmas Time, that's my album, Something About Christmas Time, let's play a game of This or That. I'm good at this game. A New York City Christmas, a New York City white Christmas or a tropical Christmas, it's always gotta be cold and it's gotta be snowy for me at Christmas. Hot cocoa or eggnog, I'm gonna go with hot cocoa. I don't even know what's in eggnog, I'm not gonna lie. Ask. Oh Holy Night or Jingle Bells? Definitely Oh Holy Night, especially when Mary J. Blige sings it. Oh. Snowball fight or making snowmen? I like to make snowmen and then pelt them with snowballs. Ugly Christmas sweaters or matching holiday pajamas? Yes, all of the above. All of the above. I like to spend all day in my ugly Christmas sweater. Ugly is subjective, by the way. I love to spend all day in my ugly Christmas sweater, and then at night I jump right into my matching pajamas. I'm not kidding either. I'm not lying about any of this. Oh, and soon I'm going to be doing an Instagram Live where you guys can see all of these great toys and things that I got from the Hallmark Channel, including some great sweaters. Christmas Eve or Christmas Day? Now, honestly, this hits me hard because it's got to be Christmas Eve. To me, Christmas Day is a lead up to December 26th, which is the saddest day of the year. So I'm all about Christmas Eve. For me, it embodies everything. It's just like where the pressure cooker builds, and that's where all the specialness comes from. So that's when Santa Claus flies around. I don't think it's a coincidence. All right, so those are the questions, guys. I want to thank you guys for joining me. My song, New York Christmas, is available on my new album, Something About Christmas Time.